As Christians, we know that part of our calling is to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with those who don't know him. After all, someone shared the gospel with us years ago at one point, so that should compel us and help us to understand that the urgency is real. Sharing it with everyone is necessary. But as you know, it's way easier said than done, isn't it? Why is it that we have the best news to share, but we're too scared to share it? If God is who he says he is, why aren't we telling more people about him? Maybe we don't know how to share the gospel. Maybe we don't know how to talk about God with other people. I think most of us have questions about how and where, when, of presenting the gospel to others. We all have fears and barriers that keep us from talking to others about the gospel. Here's how I can help you through this video series I'm calling Hello Neighbor. I'll answer some of the questions and help to address the fears you have about sharing the gospel. I'll give you some ideas how to engage with the people who come across your path every day. I simply want to encourage and motivate you to live out the Great Commission where you live, work, and play. So, what does the word evangelize mean anyways? It means basically to preach the gospel. Philip in Acts 21 was an evangelist. Some people have the gifts according to Ephesians 4. And we are called to be prepared to give a reason for the hope that we have. Those who are born again are also ambassadors. We're meant to represent and promote Jesus Christ's message. You know, honestly, I think we think too highly of ourselves. We embrace our fears way too much. We all need to learn from Martin Luther what he said so eloquently, "I did nothing. The Word did it all." There's no one way to evangelize, right? I evangelize differently here in Switzerland and in Germany, and that's a good thing. You and I are different. That's God's design. It's depending on your personality, your age, your maturity, where you live in the world. Everybody has different ways. But there are some core foundations that do not change. You know, we're all called to share it regardless. I want to help you learn how to plant those important gospel seeds. In this video series, you'll see me talking and asking people questions, spiritually opinionated questions that draws them out. It helps them to open up, all of which gets us to the gospel presentation. These questions are intended to make people contemplate and articulate their perception of God. There are many ways, as you know, to initiate gospel conversations. Some of you like to write letters or cards to family and friends, share the gospel that way. Some of you are very comfortable with leaving tracts on train seats or buses or with the check as you pay at the restaurant. Some of you like to go to your neighbor's house with cookies or coffee cake and trust God to lead in a gospel conversation that way. It doesn't matter what appetizer, questions, or conversation you have. What is critical is that we get to the main course, the wonderful gospel. Before we go further, let me ask you a simple question. Who is our neighbor? When we first hear the word neighbor, our immediate response is the person who lives to our left or right. This is, of course, accurate, but scripturally, our neighbor is more than someone we live in close proximity to. You remember the story that Jesus told? It was about a man going down from Jerusalem to Jericho. Robbers attacked him, took his possessions, and beat him and left him for half dead. The first person who saw the injured man passed by. The second did the same thing. But then a Samaritan saw the hurt man, had compassion on him and helped him, even giving money to the innkeeper to look after him while he was away. Jesus wraps up the whole story and asks the simple question, who was a true neighbor? A man with prestige answered, the man that showed mercy was a neighbor. Then Jesus told him, you go and do likewise. You might be wondering, well, okay, well, what does that mean for me? Well, three basic things. One, if you see a need and you can meet it, help. Two, it takes time and energy and resources to help those around you. And three, Jesus' words were not a suggestion. They were direct and instructive for the people of that day and for us here in 2021. We too are called to treat all people as our neighbor. Because at the end of the day, we humans are all hurting. broken and in need of some type of help from others. And when we help, serve, and give, that, my friends, is the platform for us to present the gospel seeds. Born-again Christians don't just live a nice 24/7 life and then die at 85 without ever sharing the gospel in written or verbal form. No, acts of kindness need to go hand in hand with the gospel. The lovely people with gray hair, those on the subway, someone suffering a tragedy, the man in the park, you know. There's always a person that you can help in some unique way. God gives us these wonderful, unique opportunities. We are all helpless and in need of someone to bring us hope. That is the person of Jesus Christ. Let's not forget that great story in Mark chapter 12, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. This is one of the reasons why I'm a missionary here in Europe, because people need hope. They need someone to take the initiative to come into their life and offer the ultimate gift, the gift of the gospel. As we love our neighbors, we have the opportunity to show them who Jesus is, and we will experience God's blessing in our lives. So I leave you with this question: who is your neighbor? They're waiting for you, aren't they? Maybe it's time for you to go and say, "Hello, neighbor," and see what God does. Okay, thanks for tuning in. See you next time.